Report a shot fired at officer turns up the vehicle.
We have one officer shot.
We got shots fired. Settling automatic firearm.
Copy, code red, shots fired.
We have an active shooter. We have an active shooter inside the warehouse.
Now it's Shots Fired with your host, Dinah Death Milberg, and the Lovely Krystal Powers.
What's up, guys? We are back for another episode of Shots Fired. I am still not Sig Glock and Colt, but I am myself, and I'm here with Marc for the first time ever, and Krystal Powers.
Hello.
How's everyone doing today? So we got plenty of stuff to talk about. Of course, like, when it's me by myself, there's nothing to talk about. But when there's three of us here today, we have tons of stuff to talk about.
That's always how it works out. To be fun.
Yeah, so we're going to go over the ridiculousness that is Illinois.
Wait, can I pause for a second? How do you guys know each other?
He runs our FFL department.
Yeah. Cool. Okay.
He sells guns.
I'm
make sure the guns ship.
Jack of all trades. I can do pretty much any department there.
Yeah. You've done every department there. He used to work on retail. And then what else have you done?
Started in shipping, worked in retail. Pretty much everything.
At Tactical.
Yep.
La, 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 la.
I can't do it the same as TJ. So, plenty to talk about today. Where to even begin? And then Krystal wants to talk about the raging cartel war that's going on.
It could be fun.
The video I saw of, like, gun truck after gun truck from the cartels pulling out on the highways.
Uh-huh.
I got excited personally because I'm like, dude, you could light some stuff up.
Yeah, that was movie worthy,
like,
for
no
sure.
At that point, very, like, if you see cartels rolling out with gun trucks, you just light everything up.
Yeah, that's pretty much the end of police rule in that area.
Yeah,
easily.
100%. So we'll get into that as well. Just for funs, I'm gonna come up with a question of the day because I saw this and this made me laugh. So if anybody listening to the radio show, or if you're listening to this podcast and you can comment, or if you're listening to the show, you can use the app. We have a question. For anyone who works at a bank, what is your protocol if someone puts bees in the tube things? We're not planning on doing this, but what happens if instead of depositing a check, someone deposited a tube full of bees?
Murder hornets.
Yeah. What is the plan? What is the protocol to combat that? We're curious. All right.
Wait, are you asking the audience?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Why, what'd you find?
No, I didn't look it up. I was just... No, there's no way there's a contingency for that.
So, Marc, the Illinois State Bill, what are we looking at here?
Yesterday, and all their intelligence, decided to pass House Bill 5471 and Pritzker, with the help of Moms Demand Action and all those other fun groups.
Of course.
Pushed it through and signed it, turning it basically into law immediately and effective immediately.
Yeah, this started, what, the 10th?
Yeah, started the 10th. So in the bill, I've actually got the entire thing printed out in front of me here, and I've read through it probably 6 times now. There are a total of 18 different statutes amended in this bill.
Wow.
Everywhere from medical and recreational marijuana use to how they're going to do emergency rulemaking for all sorts of different things, how they're setting up contracting. But the big parts that I wanted to bring up today, the ones that affect most people, actually don't even start. So to give you guys an idea, it's 111 pages for this bill.
Which actually, for a bill, it's not that bad.
No. And especially having 18 different things in there that work on it. But the big thing that's going to affect most people and that most people are pissed off about is actually starting on page 78, where the state of Illinois, as of now, has banned all AKs, all ARs, any assault weapon or 50 caliber center fire rifle, as well as imposed a 10 round for rifles and 15 round for handgun magazine restriction, as well as made any and all binary trigger systems or anything that can affect the rate of fire of a firearm. They've banned them completely.
So yeah. Is that the sale of those or ownership
sale
of them?
Possession of everything.
Yeah, and they're allowing you of, to keep them if you have them. Same with assault rifles.
Uh-huh.
But you have, and do you know the time period they have?
They have the until period? October 1st of this year to register all of those items with the Illinois State Police.
Okay.
How about no?
Yeah, exactly.
So, speaking of that, before we dive any further, they define what an assault rifle is, because that's a very vague term, too. So I think that's the number one thing we're going to be asked in the shop. I guarantee the Illinois listeners, that's the number one thing they're wondering is, okay, what does the state count as an assault rifle? And I'm going to say right now, our response to this, I'm not a lawyer, but at this point, don't listen to any of this.
And I'm going to back that up only because as of about 20 minutes ago, looking at Facebook, there were 80-plus sheriffs in the state of Illinois that are refusing to even acknowledge this.
Yeah. America. I love to hear these things.
The problem is, like, the state police and the highway patrol. That's what I'd worry about with Illinois. It's not the local cops and sheriffs, but stateies. And, again, if you are a sworn officer and you enforce this, you should be ashamed of yourself and you probably should be a cop.
Also, according to this bill, if you're a sworn officer, none of it even applies to you. So, legal for thee, but not for me. See how that goes.
Yeah. So, there's that. It's bad. We'll get into the list here in a second because we're getting towards a break and the list is pretty comprehensive, but it's... Would you agree with me saying that because of this bill, this now makes Illinois more restrictive than, like, Massachusetts,
100%.
California? Like, this sets a precedence. This is now a more restrictive ban, more comprehensive than any other state in the U.S. at this time.
100%. It's also, I'm a huge devil's advocate person, and I couldn't even find any loopholes in this.
No, that's the first thing I did do was try to poke at it and see, like, okay, does it leave it open? Nope. Anything you thought might be left open is trying to sneak something through they've thought of. And the penalties that we'll get into as well are, it's bad. Like, this is bad. You should, if you live in Illinois, you should be calling your state reps, your congressman, calling the governor's office, blowing him up. Not literally blowing his phone line up. I want to clarify that immediately. Or am I? No. But seriously, this is a big deal. Also, I tell you, this is a time for civil disobedience. Do not register anything. This is as unconstitutional as it gets. Would you sit there and comply if they started to print out a list of restricted words and terms that you can't speak anymore?
In all popular terms, too, you know, as in the weapons they're banning are the number one selling and most popular firearm in the U.S.
A lot of the argument right now with some of the stuff banning is, what is it, regular use or something like that?
Popular and in regular use, which the Supreme Court just, what was it, last month?
Yeah.
Has said that if they're in legal use and popular firearms at that
common
time.
Common
yeah. use. Then they can't be banned.
And I would put every AR and every AK is, at this point, more common use than probably any other firearm.
Yep.
It's one of the top-selling firearms on the market. ARs and semi-automatic rifles in general, as well as handguns, have dominated the market. So, and when they break down the restricted handguns even, it's insane.
Yep. My job at TS, where I work, is I handle all of the FFL issues. Handle all the firearm sales. I've been doing this for years. I used to work for some other big name corporations doing this, and they are easily the most common guns sold, transferred, everything. And according to the Supreme Court, they can't be banned. Yet Illinois did.
Yep. It's gonna be an interesting. And the real ironic part is they turn a bunch of law-abiding citizens who have been nothing but law-abiding citizens quickly into felons. But then they passed that act that started January 1st where cashless bail for second-degree murder, arson, kidnapping. So you can be a legit criminal and face no consequences. But if you're a law-abiding citizen, suddenly the firearms that you've had for 20 years, if you don't register them by a certain amount of time, you're now a felon. How does that make any sense whatsoever? Because I can see the argument that they're targeting this for gangbangers in Chicago and everything, and we'll get into some of the details of that, some of the charges and how it works. Except they're not charging those cases. They're letting them walk. They're not going after it. So that can't even be argued. So this is bad. For anybody living in Illinois, this is really bad. We'll get into some of the details of what they're calling a quote-unquote assault rifle, what some of the restricted items are once we get after the break, and then also some of the consequences they're saying are going to be followed from this. Be right back, guys. What's up, guys? We are back after a quick break talking about the assault weapons ban for the state of Illinois that just passed, and we're just going to dive right into what is Illinois defining as a quote-unquote assault weapon.
So looking at House Bill 5471 here, I've went through and highlighted a whole bunch of stuff, and I'm just going to kind of summarize but also read straight from it. Assault weapon means any of the following except as provided in subdivision, yada yada. A semi-automatic rifle that has a capacity to accept a detachable magazine or that may be readily modified to accept a detachable magazine if the firearm has one or more of the following: a pistol grip or thumb hole stock, any feature of capable of functioning as a protruding grip that can be held by the non-trigger hand, a folding, telescoping, thumb hole, or detachable stock, or stock that's otherwise foldable, a flash suppressor, grenade launcher, which, you know, those are easily bought, a shroud attached to the barrel that partially or completely encircles the barrel, allowing the bearer to hold the firearm with the non-trigger hand without being burned.
Which is literally just a handguard.
Yeah, any type of free-floating handguard. A semi-automatic rifle that has a fixed magazine with the capacity to accept more than 10 rounds, except for an attached tubular device designed to accept and capable of operating only with .22 caliber rimfire ammo. And a semi-automatic pistol that has capacity to accept magazine or may be readily modified to accept a detachable magazine if it has one or more of the following: threaded barrel, second pistol grip, or any other feature capable of functioning as a grip, a shroud attached to the barrel that partially or completely encircles the barrel, a flash suppressor, the capacity to accept a detachable magazine at some location outside of the pistol grip, a buffer tube, arm brace, or any other part that protrudes horizontally behind the pistol grip and is designed or redesigned to allow it to be fired from the shoulder. So all your braces are gone, just having a plain buffer tube is gone. A semi-automatic pistol that has fixed magazine capacity to accept more than 15 rounds. Any shotgun with a revolving cylinder, which there's like five still currently in production.
Yeah, the 1216, Utah's makes some. There's a few.
The Rossi Circuit Judge is one of them. A semi-automatic shotgun that has one or more of the following: pistol grip or thumb hole stock, any feature capable of functioning as a protruding grip that can be held by the non-trigger hand. So if you've got a pump action shotgun with a grip on the front of it, any type of vertical grip, that would qualify. A folding or thumb hole stock, grenade launcher, fixed magazine that can accept more than 5 rounds, capacity to attach a detachable box magazine, any semi-automatic firearm that has capacity to accept belt-fed ammunition feeding device.
Man, that's the last loophole I was going to go for.
Freedom ordinances, yeah. FR9 or whatever it is, the belt-fed 9mm is now illegal. Any firearm that has been modified to be operable as an assault weapon is defined in this section. as well as any part or combination of parts designed and or intended to convert a firearm into an assault weapon, including combination for of parts that where an assault weapon can be readily assembled. So
even having the parts to build an AR.
And say you have a Ruger 10/22, which is the most common, the most popular 22 rifle out there.
Yeah.
You can't go out and buy the Tapco AR conversion stock, because that would be an assault weapon.
Yeah, you know, many crimes have been committed with those.
Yep.
So, penalties. What if you don't comply, according to this bill, what's some of the penalties? And one of them specifically I want you to bring up, because it infuriated me.
So, from what I've been able to find in this, and again, like Alex, I am no lawyer. I just have a little bit of knowledge on reading these things. A lot of the penalties on this is felonies. It is a class 4 felony. The big one that I know Alex is wanting me to bring up, say me, Alex, Krystal here are all driving in a car. We're all Illinois residents driving in Illinois. Alex is the one driving. Me and Krystal just hopped in. We get pulled over. There's an AR in the trunk. Everyone in that vehicle is now charged with a felony.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's very...
Yeah.
Whew.
You could not even know that was in there. It could be mine and I just forgot to mention it to you or didn't tell you. And if it is an unregistered, quote-unquote, assault rifle, doesn't matter. All three of us are getting felonies. So you can now catch a felony for literally doing absolutely nothing.
The only way to prevent that is, and it states that's in the amendment here, is if that firearm is found on an individual person, then that person gets it, no one else does. But if it's in the car, say it's underneath the seat, bam, felonies.
That makes even less sense to me.
Technically, you get pulled over, be like, yeah, cop, he's got it on him, it's an assault pistol.
Yeah, it's over 15 rounds.
But, civilian, you know, arrest.
Law enforcement's excluded from this.
Yeah, which, again, not a fan of that.
Not at all.
No, that's why that's one thing I love about Barrett. Barrett, in my opinion, is one of the most slept-on gun manufacturers out there. I'm a huge Barrett fan, not just for the M82. There's so many other wonderful rifles they make. But one thing I give them major props for is when, and I'm sure they're going to do the same here with Illinois shortly, when California banned 50 cals, Barrett said they would no longer do business with the state. They've had many law enforcement requests for rifles, for M82s, and Barrett said nope. They refused to deal with the state entirely.
And that's going to hit them hard because the M82, the MRAD, Barrett makes a lot of precision long-distance rifles. Would really help out the police in Chicago.
Yeah. Well, so would actually, like, enforcing law. So here we are yet again where we're making what we're not. Illinois is making gun laws and passing bills that are not going to do a single thing to stop crime. Because, man, we just had an officer. He's a North City officer. And he comes into the shop pretty often. And the criminals know. Like, he stopped the guy. The guy admitted he had a firearm on him. And he's a 3-time felon. Walked up. He knew he was going to jail. He was very open about it. He admitted where he got the gun from, how he got the gun. He knows the game. He wasn't upset about it. He took it like a man. Criminals know what they're doing. They know they're breaking the law. This bill is only hurting law-abiding citizens, not doing anything to stop criminals whatsoever. We'll be right back after this break to talk about more reasons why we hate the stupid state of Illinois and how bad it sucks. All right, so we've kind of summarized this assault weapons ban for Illinois, talked about what all it covers, what the definition of an assault rifle is according to this bill, some of the penalties. So you want to hit them with the list? It's depressing. It's basically
everything.
We'll go through it, but to briefly summarize, if your gun is semi-auto, it is now an assault rifle. That's literally the way it reads. Your Ruger 10/22 from 1982 with a wooden stock is now an assault rifle.
Yep. So that October 1st timeline to register all your magazines, your high-capacity magazines, and your ARs or assault-style weapons, as they claim, that date's kind of significant. So every year the ISP has been tasked through this, that every year they're going to release a list on October 1st of any new firearms that are not currently included on this list. Big thing that I see that's a problem for, you know, law-abiding people and people that like to shoot is in the wording here, they have all the following rifles, copies, duplicates, variants, or altered facsimiles with the capability of any such weapon.
I'll give them this. They thought ahead and wanted to make sure they covered all their bases on this. So you can't come up with something that's similar to try to work around. It's very close-ended.
They 100%, as much as I hate this law, they did a good job of closing loopholes.
Yeah.
The writing of it. So on this list, first option is, of course, my favorite, all AK types, including every type of AK ever produced. Including, you know, Wazzer 10s, Vector Arms, SA-93, any Sega AKs, Mahdi AK-47s. So Mahdi, I don't know if a lot of people are familiar with them, but if I'm not mistaken, back in 95 is when they stopped being imported.
Yeah, that's why they're worth so much, is because they have not been imported in a very long time, and the Mahdis are probably some of the higher quality builds out there.
100%. Then Norincos that list certain models, any Polytech AK, any SKS with a detachable magazine. So all you older gentlemen that like to hunt with your SKS, magazine's detachable, no more.
Which means if you did one of those Tapco kits, now you made an assault rifle.
Yep. All AR types, including the following, AR-10, AR-15. And then it goes on to list a bunch of different options, including the Barrett Rec 7, as we were talking about, the Barrett AR-70, Bushmaster ACR, just listing a couple of them off of here, Diamondback DB-15 rifles, DPMS rifles, H&K MR-556. Friend of ours at the shop here is actually Jesse James Nomad. AR-15 rifles.
Good for him.
Listed by name.
You know why did Daniel Defense make the list?
Yes, I believe it did.
I'm so shocked because usually they don't want to list that one because that's the one that the FBI uses to set up all their active shooters with.
Yeah, all the alphabet boys give out SIG 516 rifles and MCX rifles. So, sorry, Alex, no more going to Illinois.
It's okay. I never go there anyways.
All Smith & Wesson M&P rifles.
Dude, life goals. Buy every gun on this list and drive through Illinois with it all in a truck at once.
Funny enough, I was actually, the first time I read through this, there was a couple that I was not familiar with, so I started looking at it as a shopping list on guns to buy.
Thanks, Pritzker.
Right?
You gave me new ideas for guns I have to have.
Yankee Hill Machine Company, Barrett M107A1, M82A1. This one's kind of interesting, so Beretta CX-4 Storm.
Yeah.
Are you familiar with that one, Alex?
Yeah. That's their carbine, their 9mm carbine.
That's a 9mm, 40 cal, or I believe they made a 45 version period. Carbine. Bullpup style. I mean, it's not your standard assault rifle that people would look at.
No.
Of course, you've got the FN Fiona Fowl. That's now on here. PS-90, SCAR. Any of those fun toys. Thankfully, they did think far enough ahead to include the High Point carbines, though. So, even though High Points are already illegal to import into the state of Illinois and have been
if they wanted to stop crime, they could have just listed the High Points.
Yeah, well,
and just left it
Any pop metal gun's been illegal in the state of Illinois for over 30 years now.
Yeah.
They can't even get them there. IWI Tavors. Springfield Armories. Quite a few of those on here. This one's really going to hurt a lot of people. Sturm Ruger Mini 14 Tactical.
No. Mm-hmm. So FUD rifle.
There goes all your FUD rifles. This one I also found interesting. The Thompson.
Side note, before you keep going, why does every Mini 14 owner have to refer to as clips. Have you ever heard a Mini 14 owner
not once
call it a magazine?
Not
it's,
once.
It's like part of being indoctrinated into the Mini 14 cult is you have to call it a clip.
I also don't think I've ever met a Mini 14 owner under the age of 65.
Or under 300 pounds.
Correct.
And they're usually wearing overalls.
Or have suspenders on.
Yeah. Wow. Yes.
100%.
Every time.
So this one I find interesting because a lot of people, specifically in Illinois, use it. All Thompson rifles. So, like your Thompson Contender, the interchangeable
barrels. Oh,
because
that's one of the ways they'd use for deer hunting.
Correct.
They listed that?
All, it says all Thompson rifles, including the following, and then goes down to give you a list of different models.
Wow. But so, basically, the only thing that isn't an assault rifle at this point is bolty guns, lever gats, and black powder.
Pretty much. And for all you guys up in Chicago, all the following pistols, copies, and variants are banned. So all AK pistols, sorry, but they include the Draco on here. So no more Dracos, no more Hellpups, no more crank pistols, mini Dracos. Daniel Defense Mark 18 pistol right there for you.
Wow.
So they did include that. And another Jesse James. As well as the Kel-Tec PLR-16.
I don't even know what that is.
It's a pretty interesting little rifle. It's cheaply made. Kel-Tec has a lot of cheaper guns. But they do, it takes your standard AR components, such as magazines, flash hiders, stuff like that.
Huh.
They usually run about $400. They fold up. Kind of fun to play with.
Aren't they all?
So, nah,
some on the list I would pass, but most of these, yeah.
Yeah, it does have, right underneath that, though, assault weapon does not include any firearm that is an unserviceable weapon or been made permanently inoperable, an antique or replica, manually operated by bolt, pump, lever, or slide action, unless the firearm is a shotgun with a revolving cylinder.
Wow, so they really... Man, then I... Huh? No, the KSG is still illegal.
I don't know, though.
Pistol
KS,
grip.
It does have a pistol grip. So I guess unless they make one without a pistol grip.
Which they couldn't, because it's a bullpup design. And the tubes go into the stock, so I don't see how they could.
And, well, yeah, because even with shotguns, it has to be less than 5 rounds. So KSG's version of the KS-8, whatever it is, their 8-round one, that one's not even legal anymore. Also makes me wonder about the Taurus Judge, even though it's a 410.
Yeah, it's still a shotgun.
It's still a shotgun. The Smith & Wesson Governor. I don't know, it's interesting. And one of the big things that Alex and I were talking about yesterday on it, so detachable magazine. California for a long time had it where you could have a bullet button.
Yeah.
It had to be operated by a bullet or some other piece of equipment to remove your magazine. They go in this law to actually state that that is illegal. That doesn't even count as a fixed magazine.
Yeah, it's like they decided they had to one-up California on how bad they could make their state suck.
Yeah. Yeah,
yeah, it's pretty grim, like, reading through all this and getting further and further into it. And again, they're saying you have till October to register with Illinois State Police. You have to register or destroy or turn in your firearms and your mags.
Or give them to someone out of state who is, you are then required within 30 days to notify the ISP of the fact that you've given them out of state. Give them that person's contact info, and then that person is required within 60 days to contact the ISP and say that, yes, we're going to abide by all Illinois laws.
Wait,
or what? Are they going to come into Missouri and do something?
Right. That's what I was wondering.
I have a question. So yes, these, that extensive list you just read, these are all illegal.
Correct.
Now.
Yes.
So here's a quote that I'm going to read from the Speaker of the Illinois House. If this bill were to become law, I want to be clear about something, because we're probably going to hear a lot about this in debate later. If this bill were to become law, there will be no removal of these weapons from people who already own them. It's important to highlight that we are not taking any guns away from lawful gun owners.
If you simply just go register them for everyone's safety.
Yep. They have to be registered. They're not taking them away from you. Any transfer that was started before this was signed into act, so before yesterday, any transfer, if it was started, then they, you are allowed to keep it. So no new transfers are started after yesterday for these weapons.
So if you... Wow, so you can't even buy one right now?
Nope.
So these none of these will even be for sale anymore. It's if you already have it, you can keep it if you register it.
Correct.
Which means they're going to probably have some sort of either registry database they can check, or you'll have some sort of paperwork issued, much like having an NFA item, I'm guessing. So they'll be able to demand your papers.
So what I'm seeing, they already do demand your papers, you know, with the FOID card, which is completely illegal.
Yeah.
But there is an amendment that's going to be added onto your FOID card. So I don't know if they're going to change the looks of that, that says that, yes, you have this weapon. I don't know if that will allow you to purchase new ones or not, which even being an Illinois resident, if you come over into Missouri to buy a gun, we still have to follow Illinois laws. So you can't even come to a different state and buy one.
Yeah, that's...
Well, that's interesting.
Because that's something I've already been asked on the store page is, hey, can I come buy a gun from your side of the road? No, because sadly, what is it, long guns, they have to wait 3 days?
Long guns is a three-day hold.
And then handguns have to be shipped to an FFL on their side. Well, that's not going to be a possibility anymore. And I guess gun stores could be liable. For us, if anybody wants to come from us, unfortunately, we don't house any. All of them have to be shipped to your FFL. So you can buy bolt guns from us.
Yeah.
That's about it, unfortunately. This is bad. Like I said, though, do not comply with any of this. Don't register anything. Contact everyone you can and every form of government you can. Good on the sheriffs who are saying they're not going to abide by this, but I really would like to hear, and from what I understand, they're already working on punishments for law enforcement who won't enforce this, but I want to hear the same thing from state police officers and state police chiefs and captains saying they won't enforce this either.
The big thing I found funny is all the sheriffs have used almost identical documents.
Yeah, like they just shared it and copy pasta with their name in it.
Name and county.
Good on them, but again, until we hear state police do it, I'm not getting my hopes up. So there you have it. Sucks to suck, Illinois. Sorry. We'll be right back after this break, guys.
And we're back. And I wanted to talk a little bit about the Sinaloa cartel and what the heck has been going on in Mexico.
We're going from one corrupt organization to talk about a slightly less corrupt organization.
Is it less? Yeah, less.
I would say the cartel is probably less corrupt than the Illinois government.
Well, especially because it seems like there's some, however, you know, illegal. I don't even, that word doesn't even belong in this segment. But like some sense of justice. So if you don't know what's going on, a little less than a week ago, the Sinaloa cartel is hitting back, basically, I don't know, against everybody, it seems like.
They just lashed out every direction possible.
So El Chapo, who is the head of this cartel, he's in, where is he right now? He's
in the U.S., isn't he? I believe he's imprisoned in U.S. prison.
Yeah.
So we've got him, not us, but, you know, the other criminal organization that pretends to be in charge of us.
Work in our shipping
so he's not there right now.
I was going to say janitor, but that's racist.
Oh, wow. Okay, so his son was taken by Mexican authorities. Can you guys hold it together? So his son was taken by the Mexican authorities, and so they've responded by just shooting up
everything.
You might have seen a video of their gun trucks. I don't even know what to call them. They're pickup trucks with
technicals. Yeah.
with guns loaded on them, blasting through cities. They were grounding planes.
Yeah.
At the airport. And you probably saw, I saw a video of people on a plane who were all basically cowering because somebody opened fire inside the plane, or they were...
It was from outside
the plane. Oh, it was from outside.
Yeah.
Okay.
At the plane.
And then,
they were shooting at planes trying to leave.
Because?
No idea. Apparently they were trying...
Because we're mad and we want the world to know? Is that what's going on?
We got bullets.
They were trying to inflict punishment. Because if they scare the civilians enough, the civilians will demand that the Mexican government releases him. I don't know.
I know, it seems like a good tactic.
Or they're trying to draw out the police so they could engage the police.
Yeah.
Either way, there's an aerial view of it. There is stuff burning all over. There's gunfire all over.
Well, there are a lot of civilians who were killed, too.
Yeah. The cartel does not care.
There's a report I'm looking at said 22 hours ago, or as of 22 hours ago, there's over 100 people missing from the town while El Chapo's son was captured.
And I'm not a cartel expert from my understanding, though. The Sinaloa is probably the most powerful cartel out of all the cartels currently. Not to pimp out another podcast, but the Sean Ryan podcast, he does a really, 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 really good podcast with Ed Calderon. Ed's Manifesto on Instagram is his handle. He's a former narco officer for the Mexican government, as well as it sounds like he did some intel work, some contracting work, a little bit of everything. There may have been some three-letter agency involvement with him as well. And he's got some very in-depth knowledge of the cartels, specifically Sinaloa, and what their game is. And it's really interesting, especially to find out that, you know, on one hand, our government's been involved with that from day one. But also now the new player in the game is how much influence the Chinese government now has with the cartels.
Ooh, yes.
China's buying up property in Mexico like crazy.
Mm-hmm.
They're setting up fentanyl labs.
Yeah.
Most all the fentanyl's from China. However, Chinese officials and scientists have been setting up in Mexico and setting up fentanyl labs, and the Chinese have been teaching the cartels how to produce fentanyl so they can flood the border with fentanyl.
If I can just bring up something that I usually scroll past. I don't go on Facebook hardly ever.
You're
but
not
missing
out.
I did see a post that was like, oh my God, I actually would share this. It was a picture of a folded up dollar bill on the ground. And the post was, don't pick up money off the ground, because this guy, I don't remember if it was his wife or his daughter, she picked up a folded dollar bill off the ground, and there was some, I mean, you could see it, visual white powder, and they got it tested, and it was fentanyl.
Yeah.
And the amount that was in, it wasn't a huge amount. It looked like, if you could put it in grains of sand, it looked like, I don't know, 50 grains of sand. Like, it was pretty small. You could see it, but it was really small. And they said that amount was enough to kill like 200 people.
Yeah,
insane.
It does not take a lot of it to kill people. That's what's
not
so terrifying about it is, like, they show bricks of it.
Mm-hmm.
Bricks of it can wipe out, like, cities.
Right.
So, fun little side story. Before I worked for TS, or while, I also was a 911 dispatch supervisor.
Oh, goodness.
Worked on an ambulance, all that fun stuff. I'm not going to mention the name of the company or anywhere, but it's here local in St. Louis. One night we got a call, because of course I worked overnights where all the fun happens, at a local east side establishment, which if you're in the St. Louis area, you
McDonald's.
Know what I'm talking about. Yeah. But for cardiac arrest. And then we got another call for a cardiac arrest, and another, and another. Ended up being, I believe, 8 people that went down from a bad batch of fentanyl. And then while we're responding to that...
Is there such thing as a good batch of fentanyl?
No, not at all. While we're responding to that, and we've got, you know, all our crews from Illinois, all our crews from Missouri work in this case, our medics started dropping from contact fentanyl.
No, see, that's the part that really bothers me. Like, I understand some people... I know fentanyl can be laced into, like, whatever, and if you choose to do drugs, like, hey, that's on you. But,
yeah.
Like... That really, really sucks for the emergency personnel.
We had 3 first responders go down, one of which went down while driving the patient to the hospital.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Wow.
Is this a Narcan situation? Stock up on Narcan?
100%.
So Narcan will work against that?
Fentanyl is an opioid, so any opioids, Narcan works against. It's going to take a lot more than, say, heroin, but Narcan will work.
Oh, that's good to know. Yeah, because that stuff is terrifying. Like, yes. I know that, I won't say his name just because I don't know if he wants it out there with this incident, but there's an officer I know who was searching a vehicle and it was like black tar or something he thought he came in contact with and didn't, all of a sudden started to feel not so hot. It was black tar heroin. It's a similar thing where it seems like just contact with it can really mess you up.
Yep. The biggest thing is just make sure you don't have cuts or stuff in your hand, because if it gets in there, it's obviously going to get in your system a lot faster.
Yeah, things are, this is where I get confused. We make ridiculous laws like this that only harm law-abiding citizens and turn them into criminals. We have our border open, so we have this literal war of cartels against the Mexican government.
With happening. Fentanyl labs.
Yeah, with fentanyl labs happening. Not hundreds of thousands of miles. I mean, we went and fought the Taliban 12,000 miles away with dudes in man jams and caves so they wouldn't attack us again, which I'm not even sure they did in the first place. Yeah. And we're worried about that. We're willing to do a 20-year war for that, but we have this going on in our backyard miles, not tens of miles or hundreds of miles, miles from our border, on our border, and we do nothing.
Well, not to mention all of the people that are coming across the border now.
Yeah, and nothing to stop it. Just open it up and let them come in.
Was it you that showed me the video of our leader in chief being basically the Mexican president saying, thank you for being the only president that hasn't built a single foot or a single meter of border wall?
No. Wow.
Yeah. Well, yeah, Biden was there. Let's see, what's today? He was there less than a week ago.
Yeah.
Yeah, so El Chapo's son was arrested like a few days before Biden came.
Yeah, because they were wondering if White House was going to cancel the trip because all the unrest. But I don't know what part of Mexico he went to.
Oh, I don't know either. But I know Trudeau also went. They had a Three Amigos summit.
That guy. More like the Three Stooges. Trudeau is seriously one of the dumbest politicians ever to grace this planet. Like, he makes Jimmy Carter look highly intelligent.
I don't know. At some point, I feel like, is he really unintelligent, or is this all planned, and he's just doing what he's told?
Who knows? I do like the whole theory that he's Castro's son.
I mean, they do kind of look alike.
They do. They do. It is a little frightening. And, I mean, he is a commie, so there's that.
There's no denying that.
They just had a bunch of gun laws passed, too. They just got destroyed.
No new sales or importation of handguns.
Yeah. I mean, talk about one place that finally sucks more than Illinois. Canada.
It always has. It's just cold up there.
I mean, at least Canada has, like, beautiful lakes and mountains and stuff. Illinois has...
In the 3 days of summer.
Yeah. Illinois's got Italian beef sandwiches. That's about it.
Yeah.
You might get shot trying to get one, but at least they're good. Well,
Fast Eddies.
That's it for today, guys. We will see you next week. TJ should be back.